first, you want to, you know, if it's already finished, you want to go ahead and knock off the top of layer of the finish. And then you should poly a polyurethane or varnish or something like that. You want to get that off so that the new coating you got can adhere pretty good. So get a little elbow grease in it and spend a little time knocking it off. So once you get through with that, you want to go ahead and dust it off and get it clean so your new coat can take well. So I just used a little bit of mineral spirits after I dusted it off, and I wiped it down with the mineral spirits so that can be as clean as possible. You don't want dust in your new coat. It's going to cause bubbles and it's just going to be all like, yeah, it's ugly and nasty. It's not going to be a good smooth finish. So that's one of the main things you want to do, is make sure that it's very clean. A lot of people get that part wrong. They think they just dust it off and then they put in a new coat of a finish or a paint or something on that, and you can see all that dust and dirt inside the new coat. So yeah, that's what you gotta do. Once you get that done, let it dry for a little bit, and you'll be ready. What will you be ready for? You'll be ready to put your new coat on. So over here, I'm just using some little basic stuff that the church provided. I'm doing this table for a church. I've done 3 or 4 tables for them so far, and I think I have to do maybe 2 or 3 more. So once that's dry, go ahead and get your first coat on. So all I did right here was, you know, get ready to put the first coat down. But you gotta make sure that it's stirred up good. You wanna get all that resins and stuff at the bottom of the can. Get it mixed real well, cause they buy this stuff and just have it on stock. So everything go to the bottom of it, and it won't work as well when you, if you don't stir it up too good to get it shaped. You can use anything to apply it. I just use this little small brush, and it worked real well with me. I mean, you can use a roller, you can even spray it on, but I just wanted to put a brush on it, the small brush, and do long strokes. That way it'll be real smooth and it'll be less sanded in between coats, because you have to sand in between coats if you want your finish to be optimal. It's just like painting cabinets. It's more so, it's labor intensive, but it's not really hard. If you got a lot of patience, you got a lot of patience and, you know, time to get it done right, it'll come out real beautiful. So I'm just laying these strokes down, keeping the wet edge. I'm doing plank by plank instead of the whole, you know, surface. I'm doing plank by plank and just rubbing it on, and you know, you'll have to sand it in between coats anyways to keep it smooth. So I just did it like that. Coat on top of coat. Well, not talking coat on top of coat right now, but just so much plank by plank. Take a little longer to do it plank by plank, but it's best because you won't see as many brush marks and you won't see, you know, ripples and stuff like that in your finish. Once I get one plank, I rub it on down, give it a good long stroke to make sure it's all even, and I start on the second plank. Same thing, long strokes, rub it in, keeping a wet edge, you know, so we can keep it as smooth as possible. That's all you gotta do, you know, spend a little time and you'll be good to go, because the longer time you spend on it, the better the finish will be. If you just slapping it on, trust me, it's gonna be sloppy. Just keep on doing the same thing until the whole entire tabletop is complete, and then you're gonna let it dry. This thing says you can let it dry between coats for like 6 to 8 hours. Unfortunately, I didn't have 6 to 8 hours, so I left and then I came back another day, and then that's when I sanded it and then put another coat on it. It's looking good so far. You know, all this is, it's just a clear finish, and it's used to, you know, protect the wood. These tables take a beating, and they just sitting out there in the sun all day. But however long they were sitting out there, you know, it beats it up. So this is what it, you know, protects it. Now you're letting it dry. So now you want to sand with a fine grit sandpaper, because you don't want to take off, you know, the coat that you already put down. So get something 220 on up. This is 220 what I'm using right now. Just sanding it down, just making sure everything nice and smooth and it's ready for another coat. So get after that, you know, once you get everything sanded down and everything smooth how you like it and looking good, got to do the other step again and clean it down. I didn't use mineral spirits this time. I just used a damp cloth to wipe up all that dust up, so the next time, you know, you won't see it in your finish. So all the steps that you got to just think about is just when you're doing stuff like this is make sure everything's smooth and clean. And the outcome will end up being it's real. Now you got it clean and dry. You can go ahead and proceed to laying down your second coat. If you're just putting two on, then it's the final step. But if you're gonna put more, you know, you gotta follow the steps again. You gotta sand it again and clean it again and then recoat it again. But this table was only getting two coats, so this is the final step. So just know, once it's clean, when you sand it clean, then you can put on another coat and you'll be good to go. So now the table will last you for more time. You know, if it's indoor furniture, probably just get away with two or one coat. You know, it's more so for looks now, but this is for performance. So hope y'all like this video. Hope you learned something, you know, and follow for more. Yeah, I'm going.